नमस्ते, आई एम गोविंद विश्वास, आई एम ए टीचर एंड फॉर द लास्ट 8 ईयर्स आई हैव कंपोज्ड 473 इंग्लिश पोएम्स एंड माई 4 बुक्स ऑफ इंग्लिश पोएम्स हैव बीन पब्लिश्ड इन कोलकाता एंड न्यू दिल्ली इंडिया. Now I will read a few poems from my 4th book of poems, that is the Global Poems. Now I am reading. Namaste sir, Sai Prakash ji namaste. Sai Prakash ji namaste. Page number 50, poem number 50 of this book. The title is The Great Laborer. The Great Laborer. You work from dawn to dusk untired. You don't have salary even of a shilling. You have neither grievance nor anger. Yet you are the embodiment of soft feeling. My workplace is my religious place, the most sacred place to me, you opine. You need neither order nor request for work, but you perform duty and responsibility so fine. You follow the advice of Holy Gita. You don't expect, now I repeat, you don't expect something for your action. You do your work with a tranquil mind. You worship work with complete absorption. You have no complaint against anybody else. You think everybody is your near and dear ones. At dead of night, they are in delicious slumber. Then you pray, O God, Keep them in peace. They fall ill and toss and bed in delirium. You are the lady, you are the great lady with the lamps, but you don't get a bit of it in return. You are our mother, busy for our charm. In this poem, I have drawn the great role of every mother to our life. Namaste, Rohini Beheraji, namaste. Namaste, sir. Next poem, poem number 52, page number 52, The Holiest Sign. The Holiest Shrine. The title is The Holiest Shrine. We go to the holy temples. You go to the holy churches. Some go to the holy mosque. The rest to other holy shrines. We all get mental peace there with the blessings of own God. But it is true. Universal shrine, the holiest of all, with true Lord. The other day, Father fell ill. He was admitted in a hospital. There were so many patients, physical as well as psychological. On the bed, side by side, there were sitting the Hindu, Muslim, Christian and Persian. They got cured with treatment of gods, the doctors and nurses, not any religion. Patients were talking with one another as if they were of near and dear relation. To cure is the religion of doctors and nurses, while the blood donors are the true son. That's all of the poem, my dear friends. In this poem, I have drawn the very picture that I think that the health center or the hospital is the holiest shrine because all patients from all the religions are cured there and they talk with one another on the bed side by side. Now there is no hostility, no enmity. So I think the hospital or the health center is the holiest shrine. Next poem. The child. Next poem, the child. Poem number 54, page number 54. The title is The Child. I am a child, an innocent child. Very little I am aware of this planet. I am the happiest being on earth. With simplicity, I play with many a mate. I go to the pond with them like a colt. While I cast so many fishes there, really my jaws knows no bounds then, for I take several ecstatic dips in water. I go to school with my bosom friends, hands in hands and hearts in hearts. I do lessons with attention like others, with all I play and pick up various fruits. In school, I participate in cultural programs. While I recite poem or act in a play, I do not know the vices of the society that vitiates it with severe agony. In my kingdom, there is no Pandora's box. It's a kingdom of flora and fauna, I say, with smile and joy, without stares and stain. The seniors be baptized with grace, I pray. In this poem, I have drawn the true picture of childhood. The children are innocent. They live near the heaven. They live near the God. They are too simple. They are too innocent. So the children pray to God. Oh God, please all the adults, all the seniors be baptized with the holy rays of simplicity and innocence. That's all of the poem, my dear friend. Next poem, poem number 55, page number 55. The title is The True Patriot. The True Patriot. He is a soldier, a patriotic soldier to all. To warmongers, he is the superhero. For he has killed so many enemies in war. Their bodies will go back home tomorrow. You are a brave soldier of your country. Your countrymen are very proud of you. As you have slain the so-called enemies, they are mutilated. Vultures stand in queue. The skies resounded in both the countries with lamentation of relatives of the slain. Is he a true patriot? Are you a real patriot? For you kill one another on the blind lane. Neither he nor you construct a little, but it is true, you both destruct a lot. You incarnate die in the ocean with red blood. War or civil war begins. You go under the sword. The cultivators, laborers and blacksmiths and potters, masons, weavers and teachers construct his time immemorial for mankind. They are the true patriots, the silent pitchers. That's all of the poem, my dear friends. Hello, my dear friend, Mildred Parji, namaste. In this poem, I have drawn একটা ভেরি ট্র্যাজিক, ভেরি প্যাথেটিক পিকচার। মেনি অফ আস থিঙ্ক দ্য ওয়ার মঙ্গার্স থিঙ্ক দ্য স্টেটসম্যান থিঙ্ক দ্যাট দ্য সোলজার্স আর ট্রু প্যাট্রিয়ট বিকজ দ্য সোলজার্স কিল এনিমিস সো দ্য সোলজার্স আর ট্রু প্যাট্রিয়টস অ্যাকর্ডিং টু দ্য ওয়ার মঙ্গার্স অ্যান্ড ওয়ার ট্রেডার্স বাট আই থিঙ্ক দ্য কাল্টিভেটর্স লিবারার্স ব্ল্যাক মিলস পটার্স মেশনস উইভার্স অ্যান্ড টিচার্স আর দ্য ট্রু প্যাট্রিয়টস বিকজ দে ডোন্ট ডিস্ট্রয় দে অনলি কনস্ট্রাক্ট দে ডোন্ট ডিস্ট্রাক্ট দে অনলি কনস্ট্রাক্ট সো আই থিঙ্ক দে আর দ্য ট্রু প্যাট্রিয়টস নট দ্য সোলজার্স অনলি দ্য কাল্টিভেটর্স নাও আই রিপিট দ্য কাল্টিভেটর্স লেবারার্স টিচার্স আর দ্য ট্রু প্যাট্রিয়টস দ্যাটস অল অফ দ্য পোয়েম মাই ডিয়ার ফ্রেন্ডস নেক্সট পোয়েম নেক্সট পোয়েম পোয়েম নাম্বার 62 পেজ নাম্বার 62 অফ দিস বুক দ্য গ্লোবাল পোয়েমস দ্য টাইটেল ইজ মাই লাংস বার্ন মাই লাংস বার্ন উই অল নো দ্যাট এ ফিউ মান্থস এগো দেয়ার ওয়াজ হরিবল ফায়ার infernal fire in the jungles of the Amazon and a large part of the Amazon forest or the Amazon jungle were destroyed but we all know that the Amazon is the lung of this blue planet if our lung is destroyed or lung is ruined we can't survive My poem is My Lungs Burn. I am Earth. I am the mother of you all. Oh, flora and fauna, I was happy for ages. Really, I am not well. I am agonized now, as I cannot breathe a little for days. I took humans as my great children. But I did not know, so greedy they are. They always kill trees, my dumb children, who give me precious oxygen and fresh air. Oh humans, for your greed I am sick now. I cannot bear with this warmer climate. You produce smoke and I feel suffocated. My lungs, Amazon burns. Save me at any rate. No doubt the Amazon jungle is my life. Oh humans, you are the hungry hyenas. Your greed has set fire to my dear Amazon. My dumb children burn alive. Stop civil wars. I am choked as my lungs have severely burnt. Please, Put out the fire, oh my great children, I cry, where are my beautiful dumb children? I am dying, don't kill them, please save them. That's all of the poem, my dear friends. Next poem. Poem number 64, page number 64. The title is Life and Death. The title is Life and Death. Oh life, you are the kingdom of light. And it is full of air and unmixed joy. We can inhale to our heart's content. Where we can visualize and enjoy. Oh death, you are the world of darkness. It is as dark as the horrible Hades. Everything is invisible to our eyes. Here is no air. We feel suffocated for ages. O life, you are the highest tableland where people are engaged in activities. Our mind and body vibrate with thrills. Here we get peace with gentle breeze. O death, you are the abysmal dark gods where men huddle and grope for light. Where are sorrows, sufferings and pains? We fear, we shudder, we die, but we fight. We are on the ledge of a high mountain. Just beside lies the fathomless Grand Canyon. From mundane world to the darkness inferno, no communications, we are lost into oblivion. That's all of the poem, my dear friends. Next poem, poem number 65, page number 65 of this book, The Global Poems. The title is Enough is Enough. Enough is Enough. Now I repeat, the title is Enough is Enough. The rivers have been flowing not with water, but with sad, salty tears of the unlucky men. They are not with rainwater or ice-melted water. The salty tears of the rivers made the seas saline. Thousands of battles were fought for centuries. Millions of soldiers and people were brutally slain. Their body and tears flowed down the rivers like the Ganga, Congo, Thames and Amazon River. Then warmonger politicians and war traders made 200 countries till the very day. Millions of fathers, brothers, and husbands have been killed. They could live with a ray. So many famines, natural or man-made, have assassinated crowds of people, helpless people, for lack of a barn bread or a bowl of fan. The unkind rulers did nothing but took toll. We live in the postmodern, promising 21st century. Till now, too much happened that caused our miseries. At this crucial moment of our human civilization, we need one world, one nation, without a reach. That's all of the poem. The message of this poem is written at the end of the poem. We need one world, one nation without a reach. That means we all know that since time immemorial, hundreds and thousands of battles have been fought. And millions of innocent men and women and children have been killed. Till today, directly or indirectly, battles are being fought. The battles create a lot of miseries to the affected people. So I think enough is enough. There should not be any battle, any war, civil war or foreign invasion. We all the people have every right from Australia, Philippines, Asia, Africa and America and Europe. We all the people have every right to live in happiness, peace and prosperity. So we need one world and one nation. That's all of the poem, my dear friends. Next poem. नेक्स्ट पोएम, पोएम नंबर 72, पेज नंबर 72, ए चाइल्ड टू फादर, द टाइटल इज ए चाइल्ड टू फादर। नाउ रिपीट, ए चाइल्ड टू फादर। द फादर मे बी ह्यूमन फादर और गॉड। ए चाइल्ड टू फादर, ओ फादर, आई एम योर हंग्री चाइल्ड, आई हैव नॉट ईटन फॉर डेज, इवन ए मोर्सेल ऑफ स्टेल राइस, स्टोमक बर्न्स एंड आई गेज, ओ माई फादर, डू यू वॉन्ट आई लिव विदाउट ईटिंग ए ग्रेन, कम विद ए हैंडफुल ऑफ राइस, आई एम स्टार्व्ड, आई कैंट बियर पेन, We were so poor, you know, that I was married to an aged. He tortured and abandoned me. I am sold like a bird. I am caged. Are you deaf, dumb and blind? You don't hear, talk or see. I howl, I sob, my throat soaks. Oh, father, please come and save me. Are you really my loving father? How can you tolerate child sufferings? One child gets all and everything, another gets nothing. Are you biased? I am muttering. That's all of the poem. In this poem, I have tried my best to draw the tragic and pathetic life of a very poor child. He is praying to his father. He is praying to father. Why he is suffering? He has committed no sin, but he is suffering. That's all of the poem, my dear friends. Next and last, I am reading another poem. Next poem, 73, poem number 73, page number 73, and the title is Non-Human Families Cry. Non-human families cry. The title is Non-human families cry. We are baby birds sitting in the small nest, weak, frail and helpless, waiting for mother. She has gone far away in search of food for her very little children, so dear to her. We waited and waited till late at night, really so thirsty and hungry, about to die. But our beloved mother did not come back. We are dying, oh mom, for you we cry. Oh dear darling, I can't bear, my agony knows no bounds and I rue. I was procuring food. Cruel man shot at me. I am crying not with agony, but for you. We are puppies or kittens or baby monkeys. We know only our mother like your babies. Always we are very much dependent upon them. We dream our mom is coming with food for us. Oh, my heart joy, humans pelted stones at me. I became injured. They beat me with the rod. My heart is rending for my babies, my family. Don't kill them, please. I am going under the sword. That's all of the poem, my dear friends. In this poem, I have drawn the pains, the agonies of the of all the non-human families. The non-human families also feel like us. The dogs, the cats, or the birds, they all have families like us. So we don't shoot at them, or we should not pair stones at them, because they are children, they are babies, are waiting for their parents. So we should not kill the birds, we should not kill the dogs, we should not kill the cats. They are also the children of Mother Earth. And that's all of the poem, my dear friends. In this poem, I have composed a very true picture, a very true picture that happened hundreds of years ago in an African country. The poem is written with the true story of the black Africans. It was happened hundreds of years ago. Now I am reading. Title is The Sole Black Africans. The title is The Sole Black Africans. It was 30th December 1745 in Ghana, Africa. My little son Kawami was playing over there. My husband Kweku was busy in collecting woods. Pagan we were, but we were happy without fear. Here we lived, hundreds of families with peace. We were truly happy with trees and pagan gods. My little daughter Lulu was reading the primer. The sky got clouded and arrived the masked lords. You arrived in thunder and lightning to us, with gorgeous dress, a book, and a gun in hand. We got speechless with awe and veneration. We had to leave our ancestral promised land. We were cruelly sold and resold at every slave markets. Then we were exported to America at a stormy night. In a very large ship, we were huddled together. My children were crying in acute fever and appetite. They were throbbing, "Mom, Mom, water, Mom, water." They did not give water. I was so helpless. Suddenly, they caught hold of my children and threw into sea water. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Moses. It's a very true poem. We all know that. Hundreds of years ago, the black Africans had been living in happiness and peace with the trees and plants and pagan gods. But the civilized people from the Europe arrived in the pagan African countries. The proud European countries brutally caught hold of the innocent black Africans and the black Africans were sold and resold in many slave markets. In this picture, I have drawn the very tragic picture that a black African family was sold and resold, and at last it was transported. It was being transported to America. The little children of that black family were suffering from fever. They wanted, the little child wanted, please water, please give me water, please give me water. But the proud European civilization caught hold of them and threw them in the abysmal water of the Atlantic Ocean. We all know that Jesus is kind, Moses is kind, all the gods are kind. But my question is, if the black Africans were not the children of Jesus or Moses or any gods, why they were thrown in the abysmal deep water and killed? That is the question. It's a very pathetic and tragic picture. That's all of the poem, my dear friends. Tomorrow I will come Facebook Live at 7 p.m. Indian time or Greenwich Mean Time plus 5:30 hours. And my dear friends, I want to inform you that I am going to organize my next virtual poetry festival with Google Meetup on the 27th June at 6 p.m. Indian time or Greenwich Mean Time plus 5:30 hours. My dear friends, if you want to join, please write me in the Facebook comment box. Okay, my dear friends, thank you. Goodbye.